After reading some of your comments in our video about the two new Inazuma artifacts, link will be in the top corner right of the screen by the way, some of you said that we are somehow spreading misinformation about the Shimenawa's reminiscence. Well, about it being bad on Hu Tao and Child, but it ain't about Child in this video. Which piqued our curiosity leads to this video, where we'll be taking a look into this case with calculations. Mainly, the spotlight of this video will be Yoimiya, but Hu Tao will be our test subject, as Yoimiya is not yet released. We'll also see which of these two sets are best on these two amazing DPS, the Crimson Witch or the Shimenawa's Reminiscence. Before starting, all of these calculations are done by a website we found, which link will be down below in the description, and we know that this is a reliable Genshin calculator since we've used it before in some of our previous videos. Link on how it works will be down below in the description. Quick disclaimer, we did the calculations ourselves, but we are human and we can make mistakes. So if you do spot any mistakes in the calculations or a flaw in our logic, then feel free to comment it down below, but please be nice and respectful while speaking your mind. Anyways, enjoy the video. We took so long to make this video, and had to calculate most of this manually, like the Shimenawa set since it's not released, and also the DPS output of both of these artifacts. Our channel is also very close to 1000 subscribers, so if you want to help us or support us, liking, sharing this video, and subscribing will be massive help for the both of us. Discord link will also be down below in the description if you want to chill and chat with us. And with that said, let's get right into the video. To start, after selecting Hu Tao as her test subject, we'll select several conditions for her. She'll be at level 90 with level 1 talents wielding level 90 Staff of Homa, cause why not? With its passive turned off, okay? And using max level artifacts, with her 3 controllable pieces being Timepiece Attack, Goblet Fire Damage Bonus, and Circlet will be crit rate to make her DPS more consistent. To make things simple, we'll also remove all the substats from our artifacts, since that is not a matter of importance for our calculations. We also made sure she will be alone in her party to avoid any buffs from any characters or elemental resonance. Hu Tao will not be using her passive skill, 33% fire damage bonus, and her HP will be above 50% the whole time, since the results will more or less be the same in conclusion. Anyways, yes. This video will focus on comparing both of these artifact sets and not hybrids, like for example, Crimson Witch plus Shimenawa, or Gladiator plus Crimson Witch, and so on. We will also be focusing on Pyro Damage Bonus as our calculation output, since that's what Hu Tao and Yoimiya do most of the time when they're dealing DPS. Then we'll see how much DPS is lost from Hu Tao's and Yoimiya's burst after using the Shimenawa set, and comparing it to when they used the Crimson set, with the burst. Sorry. We'll also see the vaporized damage output in the end, then comparing both DPS output with Hu Tao's charge attack, amount she can do while her skill is active, with and without her burst on these two different sets. First, we'll be checking these artifacts on Yoimiya, in which we will take focus on her normal attack 1-6 and the charge attack, without the burst because Yoimiya will be focusing most on her basic attacks. With the calculations on screen, which is where 4-piece bonuses are off, the Crimson Witch set is able to win, as you can see, as it provides 22.5% fire damage bonus due to its 4-piece bonus. A part of its 4-piece bonus is actually always active, since we're in a situation where Hu Tao's and Yoimiya's skill is activated, which will trigger the 4-piece bonus for 10 seconds. Unlike the Shimenawa set, who only gets an 80% attack buff. But with Shimenawa's 4-piece bonus active, adding a 50% damage into Yoi's normal charge attack and plunge attack, on the cost of losing 15 energy from your burst, in this case, the Shimenawa set is able to win significantly against the Crimson Witch set. But don't forget that the Crimson set shines most while doing elemental reactions. Here we'll be checking the difference between both sets while vaporizing, because vaporize is the most consistent reaction that we can use on both DPS, with supports like Xing Chu for example. And we won't be looking at overload because Electro sucks. Anyways. With the calculations on screen, with again the Shimenawa's passive off, the Crimson set obviously won by a significant amount, which is obvious. So we'll skip the explanation for this bit and get into the juicy bits. With both 4-piece bonus on and enemies affected by Hydro, the Shimenawa set is able to take the win, not by much, defeating the 4-piece bonus Crimson set. Which in conclusion, we can confirm that the Shimenawa set is indeed better on Yoimiya than the Crimson set, but in cost of her burst not being active most of the time. But since her multipliers are small, then it's not going to make much of a difference. But we shouldn't forget this little detail where Yoimiya's burst can mark enemies, and that mark will do AoE damage over time when you hit enemies, kinda like Child, and which makes both of these sets more or less equal with each other, or the Shimenawa winning just slightly in terms of DPS on their best conditions. Next, with that said, we'll get into Hu Tao and see if she does better on the Crimson set with her burst or without her burst with the Shimenawa set in terms of max DPS output. We'll be taking her charge attack damage in this case, her skill stays active for 10 seconds, and on her best condition, with the sprint cancelling, she can do 10 thrusts in this 10 seconds, which each has the DPS of 9866, which we multiply by 10, which equals to 98,760. Add it with her bursts with all passives off, and the enemies not affected with any elements. We'll skip this as the Crimson set will definitely win with a 15% fire damage bonus. So we'll skip onto the part where both sets are in their best conditions with all of the passives on, since with the 50% off, Shimenawa set will lose on everything. So the Crimson set full damage output in one round with her burst will have 22,008, which we add to 98,660, which equals to 120,668. While the Shimenawa on one round without Hu Tao's burst has a charge attack damage of 104,990, which lost to the Crimson set. But Hu Tao won't have her burst all the time, so we'll try to approach this in a different way to make things less biased. So let's say Hu Tao can burst twice. So let's say Hu Tao can burst once in twice skill activation, and we'll take 10 rounds and see the average. With everything calculated, the Crimson set will have 109,664, which is still bigger than the Shimenawa set on 104,990. And so, in conclusion, Hu Tao will do better in the Crimson set rather than the Shimenawa set. So here is your answer for those who wonder about this case. But the Shimenawa can still have the burst active in a very rare occasion, which is incredibly hard to control, resulting it in being able to win in DPS, but again, in rare occasions. So in convenience, it's no question that the Crimson set won, but if you somehow are able to control these conditions, the Shimenawa set will be a better choice for you. I, Yanggu, personally prefer the Crimson set, as it is more reliable, consistent, and convenient for me. I like the Shimenawa set, even if it does more DPS overall, but one small mistake will result in an inevitable massive DPS loss. Activating her skill will also take 15 energy, so you can't do the trick of directly doing a melt slash vaporize nuke with her burst, unless if it's synced true and timed correctly, as you also need to recharge that 15 energy in a span of 10 seconds. As for Fallings' opinion, he thinks that the Crimson Witch set is overall a better option due to it being easier to control most of the time. However, if you can just time it right and have the right support to generate energy fast enough for Hu Tao's burst, then the Shimenawa's reminiscence would be viable for her. As an addition, this overcomplicates Hu Tao's playstyle, which is not that bad as you can get new experience on playing her. Furthermore, Hu Tao with Shimenawas can deal higher damage with its 50% buff, making Hu Tao without Elemental Mastery can do fake vaporize, quote-unquote fake vaporize, damage which is a 1.5 times buff. In conclusion, Crimson set is overall still the better choice due to its consistency, convenience, and reliability. However, if you want to play Genshin Impact in Dark Souls mode, slash in a more complicated method, then that can also potentially do more damage, then Shimenawa's would be the better choice for you. In addition to the conclusion, for non-meta-based players, Hu Tao does these lines saying Sayonara or Shanala when she does her burst.
Sayonara!
And if you do want to hear that, then the Shimenawa Reminiscence set suck, because you won't be able to spam as much as the Crimson set. Oh yes, we're here for the VAs, am I right? That is the end of the video. This was really hard to make, so if you do find this video useful at any point, please consider liking, sharing this video, and subscribing. Discord link will also be down below in the description. And with all of that said, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye!
Yeah.